failure. It's a part of every entrepreneur's journey. And in this video, I'm going to share with you some practical, real-world tips on how you can handle and maybe prevent failure. I'm Dr. Srikant Sola, cardiologist turned entrepreneur. Welcome to the Startup Clinic. First of all, failure happens to everybody. It happens in every startup. And because of that, you need to plan for it in every action plan, in every operations plan, in every project. You need to identify the risk and understand how you're going to mitigate those risks. It also means you have to have backups, whether it's backups in terms of people, in technology, hardware, or software. One of the reasons why our Pure Skies technology is so resistant with uptime of almost 100% is because we built so many redundancies in case of some failure or the other. So have a plan and have backups. Second, failure is going to happen. It's what we've been saying since the beginning. When it does happen, stay calm. Don't get stressed, don't get excited, don't get hyper, don't lose your temper. Do what is right. Always follow the path of Dharma. Never veer from that. Always tell the truth. Be simple and honest in how you're going to handle that failure, whether it's to yourself, to your own team, or to your customers and other stakeholders. When failure does happen, stay calm and do what's right. Third, after the event is over, you need to learn from that event. What happened? Do a root cause analysis to figure out what went wrong and improve from it. Each failure does not have to be the end. Rather, it can be an opportunity for improvement. I remember when Pure Skies was first installed at one of our customer sites in the cold part of the country, we realized that our technology, at least at that time, was not up to the mark for dealing with cold, high humidity conditions. We improved our technology, and today we're able to handle those conditions easily. It was a failure for us. We learned from it, and we're far better today. You can do the same with each failure you come across. Okay, so you've planned and mitigated for possible failure. If it does happen, you stayed as cool as a cucumber. After the event, you learned from it to make yourself, your team, and your product better. But in the aftermath, what I suggest you do is, first, don't live in the past. Second, don't live in regrets for what happened. Learn from it. And third, use that failure as a stepping stone to move forward. If you can do these things, failure actually becomes opportunity.